Talk with Liquidshano 1973 podcast, where nothing is off limits in this crazy thing we call life. So sit back, relax, and let's go ahead and start talking. Here's your host, Shane Lajita.
Good morning, folks. I'm hoping that everybody is having as good a morning as I am, as I'm sitting here with my Yeti filled with dark roast Folgers today. No top shelf name brand kind of stuff, but Folgers dark roast with I got the sugar-free sweet Italian cream creamer that I love, and I've shared with many people to say that it's a great alternative to the sweet sugary stuff that we normally used to have in a lot of our coffees. Although I'll be honest with you, I'm a black coffee guy a lot of times, but being married to my beautiful wife and best friend for almost 20 years, she got me into a lot of the sweeter stuff for the coffees. So being in the Navy for 10 years, all we did is drank the black coffee and got hair on our chest, and we were good to go, and we're up and about, and caffeine helped us, and we were ready to kick butt and take names, right? But the sweeter, finer things in life have overcome me a lot of times, but I need to stay away from the sugars, so I go with that. So first of all, I just wanted to thank everybody. Yesterday, I got a lot of great comments on podcast 75 and some other ones, and some new listeners that I have that are out there that have just started listening and started binge listening and got the links to it and have really started to subscribe to it and have dove right into listening to the podcast. And I'll be honest with you, I look forward to every day that I do get out and I do a podcast or write coffee talks or whatever, the inspiration that I have or the amount of feedback and love that I get from all of you to do this and continue moving forward and share my thoughts and just, you know, different tips on the journey and those kind of things and how it helps to inspire people. I mean, I'm humbled so much to know that my words can help other people. But on the same hand, I'm just so appreciative of the fact that you take the time to listen to this guy up here in Scarborough, Maine, that's talking into his little office here with a microphone in front of a computer that's just talking about life. So I'm completely floored and humbled and appreciative of each and every one of you guys to be able to share with me your thoughts and your positivity and all that stuff. And I'm just humbled and appreciative of each and every one of you for listening every single day and sharing. Keep sharing the word about the Liquidshano 1973 podcast, right? Share the links, send it out. I'm getting a new shirt, actually. I just ordered from another company. I ordered it through Amazon, actually. It's Ask Me About My Podcast. So it's going to spark up some dialogue and conversation because, you know, I got to get uncomfortable and start to spread my wings a little bit and really put myself out there. It's nerve-wracking when you think about you're talking into a microphone to be able to talk to people about life journey. I'm not where I want to be completely yet, but I've lived a really good journey so far to share some thoughts and some insight and just different things of the struggles and the successes. But I'll tell you, it's nerve-wracking, and if it wasn't for people like Jonathan Mudhustler and other folks to be able to say, you need to put yourself out there because you've got good stuff to share, and you should share, and you should continue to put one foot in front of the other and just put yourself out there. I would have never done that before. So thank you to all of you, all the supporters of the podcast, and I'm looking forward to continued success and moving forward and really growing this into something bigger and better. So today I wanted to share with you guys a little bit of what I had talked about on my coffee talk this morning, and I shared an image that I grabbed off of. So I was scouring through LinkedIn yesterday, and I was looking through some business articles and things like that or whatever that I like to share with some of the business owners that I work with and some of the folks, co-workers and different stuff. And LinkedIn's great because you can really kind of keep it less about the politics and the other stuff with Facebook. You can really keep it focused down to growth opportunities, business opportunities, and just being a more well-rounded, business-minded person. So I dove in and I saw this one piece that somebody had shared. It was a photo, and it was very simple. They didn't even put any words on it. They just shared the photo, much like you would do like a meme or a photo on Facebook. But on there, it was about a 20 to 25 itemed list of simple formula for living. Okay. So I want to go over a couple of these and I want to share my thoughts on them because there's not a lot of words that I can use or even talk about that's going to really help to make it any better than what it is, just in simple writing form. Now, I posted it on No Finish Line Nation this morning and I put it on Connect, and there's some other areas that I have it on. Instagram, I actually posted it on too because it was really inspirational to me and it really stood out to me. So, simple formula for living. Let's talk about it, right? I'm going to go through these items and I might touch on a couple of them and elaborate on them, what stood out to me and what really makes a lot of sense and where it really molds itself or really kind of brings itself into what I do in my life. And I think it's quite telling. If you could type this thing out, right, print it, do whatever you have to do, save it on your phone, and be able to utilize it to tap into on those days when you're having a rough day or you forget or you're going astray from your journey, right? And you're starting to either slide a certain direction or you're starting to do something, really tap into these things because it can really help you, okay? So let's go right through it. The first one is live beneath your means. So don't overspend, right? That's something that we all want to try to be able to achieve. Live within your means and be smart with your money and those kind of things, right? Return everything you borrow, absolutely. You don't want to be in debt to anybody, so really just give everything you can back to whoever it is that you borrowed it from, right? I think it's a simple gesture. Stop blaming other people. Holy smokes, right? You know, we talk a lot about making sure we look at ourselves in the mirror and making sure that we are well-versed and well-prepared to be able to move in this journey, but a lot of times we blame other things for our faults and the things that we try to accomplish in life, we blame others for being the ones that stop and get in our ways. So think about that, right? Stop blaming other people and really focus in on what you can do to change the outcome of what you're trying to work on. I think that's huge. Okay. Let's see. Admit it when you make a mistake. Here's a hard one for a lot of people. Some people that are trying to be able to do the things that they have to do, whether it's in their journey or whether it's through their careers or whatever, admit it when you make mistakes. It's a really difficult thing because human nature is you don't want to make mistakes. You don't want to look like a fool in front of other people. So don't be afraid to admit that when you make those mistakes, because you can learn from those, which is a later bullet point. Okay. We're going to go right through these here. Give clothes not worn to charity. That's something I always talk about giving back to others. Do something nice and try not to get caught, right? Just do something nice for somebody. Be like that secret Santa person that be able to drop off a gift for somebody, or somebody that puts a $100 bill in someone's mailbox for the holidays, or goes and pays off their layaway items at Walmart or something like that or whatever without them even knowing, and just pays it and walks away. So, but try not to get caught is a really good gesture. It's because you're just doing something selflessly and not need any accolades to being able to do it. Listen more and talk less. Here's something that I learned yesterday. I read another article on LinkedIn, actually, about making sure that people have the chance to be able to complete their sentences and their thoughts without you interrupting or butting in, to be able to, even if you're doing it in agreement when somebody's having a conversation. So you let somebody finish all of their comments all the way through, and then you can go ahead and add color afterwards, or just let it sit there and simmer. Listen to what the people are saying around you, because you never know what you're going to glean from them. You never know what you're going to get from their journeys, what their life has been, what they've been through in their lives. They can add so much more color to your life. And if you're too busy talking, you're never going to be able to learn from those folks. And I think it's really important to remember that. I think it's a really big one. Listen more, talk less. Okay. Every day, take a 30-minute walk. That's something that I try to really incorporate with my Fitbit reminders and with my phone to be able to give me the reminder to go for walks every hour or so. Like, even if it's only for like 250 steps, if it's not more than that, then keep on moving. But 30 minutes each day, try to add it up to going for just a walk to get out of your seat, move up and out. Or if you're a road traveler, stop by somewhere and go for a walk. Okay. Strive for excellence, not perfection. We talk about this all the time. If you're striving for perfection, you're never going to succeed. It's point blank and simple. Do not sit there and try to beat yourself up over the fact that you're not perfect, okay? You strive just to be excellent. Strive to be the best that you can be. That's all you can try to do. And if you don't succeed in the things that you're trying to be able to succeed at that moment in time, remember to think about all the things that you did getting there. and how successful you were in those small incremental points or those barometer or temperature gauges that along the way that you were successful in the things that you were doing, okay? Be on time. Don't make excuses. That's pretty simple. I'm a military man. I always believe in being on time. And if you are 10 minutes early, you're running late. All right. Don't argue. Get organized. Yeah. So instead of bringing out the stubborn self of your own, stop arguing and get organized. Get focused on the things you have to do and the task at hand. Be kind to unkind people. Holy smokes. Think about that. Be kind to unkind people. So it's interesting because we always learn or have been taught since we've been children to try to turn the other cheek or try not to fight back against people that are against you. We try to tell our kids these days about bullies to step away and rise above and do the things you have to do to continue moving forward. It's the same exact thing in my journey. It's interesting because a lot of the different steps that we've taken, whether through the podcast or through No Finish Line Nation and stuff like that, it's interesting that we have a bunch of people that get together to talk about really positive things. And it was funny because we had caught a lot of hell for doing that, for stepping out and doing the things that we're doing because we feel like we can make a really major impact and do a lot of great things. And a lot of people really got mean and vicious. And so our theme, a lot of times, us as admins of No Finish Line Nation and me myself with my wife, was I rise above, I don't stoop to the level, and I'm going to continue to be nice and be kind and not interact with these folks that just continued to try to break me down. So think about that, right? Be kind to unkind people because it's only, if you kill them with kindness, they'll either walk away, they'll fizzle out, or you're just going to keep on killing them with the positivity that you bring to the table. So it's really important. Okay. To continue moving on here, let someone cut ahead of you in line. Awesome. That's a great gesture. Take the time to be alone. Here's a really important one. Take the time to be alone. Have your you time. If it's going in to do some yoga, if it's meditation, if it's going for a walk or whatever, you need to get away from the hustle and bustle and the rigmarole of just crazy life going on, right? And you need to step outside and do the things that are necessary for you for that self-care. You got to do it. It's so important. You have to have your time alone. Because if you're a parent, you know how crazy it can be. If you're a caretaker, you know how crazy that could be. If you're working a 6-day-a-week job or an 80-hour-a-week job, you know exactly how hard that is. And if you don't have your you time and time for you to decompress, to think about things other than the things that are stressing you out, more peaceful thoughts or things like that, it really will add some stress to your heart and it could be a bad thing in the long run. So take the time to be alone. Cultivate good manners is another thing. We teach our children to say please and thank you all the time, but why the hell is we as adults, we don't do it? Why can't we say please and thank you and be kinder and gentler and nicer to people around us? Makes a lot of sense when you think about it. And we could probably get a whole lot more out of life if we're just a little bit nicer and a little bit kinder to other people. And in today's society, with everything we got going on out there in the world and the amount of vitriol and hate and animosity that's going on all around us, it's even more important now to make sure that we are taking the time to cultivate those good manners and be kind to others. Be humble. That's another piece. One of the biggest things that I always try to be able to incorporate in my life is being humble at all times. Some of the greatest sports people in the world have an image about themselves sometimes as not being very nice people, and they're cocky or they're overconfident. And those sports people, those folks that are in sports, a lot of your sports fans don't like them because they are that cocky, overconfident, crazy, uber aggressive personality, and they're not liked very well, right? But if you're humbled and you take fame, fortune, anything like that, or success in general, or let's say, for instance, you've lost 50 pounds and you're proud of that 50 pounds, but you know that it's taken you a lot to get there, that humility piece is the part that people can relate to, and they say, oh, tell me more about that. A lot of people have told me in my journey with Coffee Talks and with the podcast, that's one of the reasons that they connect so well is because I'm humbled. And I know that I'm just a guy trying to be able to be healthy. That's all I'm trying to do. And I stay grounded like that. My wife does it very well. She keeps me grounded so well to make sure that I stay humbled. So I love her for it. Realize and accept that life isn't fair. How true this is, right? Instead of us always living in the space of, I can't believe life's not fair like that. Well, life isn't fair sometimes. It isn't. And it's going to deal you bad cards. So realizing that fact and living in that space, knowing that that will happen and how you respond to it is even more important than trying to be able to fix it or change the way that life can deal you those cards. Next is know when to keep your mouth shut. So this one's difficult for me because I know I've always just spoke up whenever needed to, if I'm in meetings or I'm around other people. But again, remember what I said earlier? Remember the earlier one that says, listen more instead of talking more? Same exact concept for me. I got to learn to keep my mouth shut sometimes because there's so many important things and so many nuggets of great information that is being said all around me that I can really learn from a lot more people. Go an entire day without criticizing anyone. I'll tell you how hard this would be for a lot of people. Whether it's looking at the TV at a model that's on TV that you look at and see how well kept together she is, and you're looking at yourself in your yoga pants or your sweatpants, and you're looking at yourself with your hair all a fluff, and you're looking at the TV and you're going, oh man, are you serious? Like, really? Oh, she's got makeup artist or whatever, and oh, you know, she really doesn't look that way. Stop criticizing. You know, take away that part of your life. If you could stop criticizing other people, do you know how nice your life would be? I mean, it puts you in a place where, although you think that it makes you feel better, and you think that if you break somebody else down to be able to come down to your level, it's going to make you feel better about yourself. Well, that's incorrect. Because what happens is that you then are living in a negative space. And if you're living in a negative space, you'll see that an hour later or 2 hours later, you're going to respond in a way that you normally don't respond, and you're going to be in a negative place for yourself, and you won't even know it. Trust me. Surround yourself with positive thoughts and stop criticizing. Try it for one day. See if you can go one full day without criticizing someone, and then after the day is over, write down your thoughts of how it made you feel. You should try it. I've done it. It's very helpful. Okay. Learn from the past and plan for the future is another one. Okay. So huge, right? We talk about all the time that I can't live in the past, but I can learn from the past. I can learn from all the things that I've done in the past that have helped me succeed, that have caused me to fail, stumble, fall, all those things. And I put actions into motion to make sure that I try not to do that moving forward. So that's a way that I can plan for the future. Live in the present, as we talk about a lot. And here's the last two. These are pretty important. Don't sweat the small stuff. Because it's all small stuff, right? Don't sweat the small stuff. We talk about that all the time. Don't worry about the little things. But guess what? Everything in life are little things. Everything. We may think it's the most big, huge, monumental thing that's happening in our lives, and our lives are coming to a crumbling halt, and we're having the worst times ever. But at the end of the day, think about it. What doesn't kill you only makes you stronger. And those little things that may seem like they're huge are just that. They're little. They're little things in the grand scheme of things when you have more important things in your life to worry about and live with, right? More people to love. More things to do for the better and the good of humanity. More giving back to others. More spreading love. All those things that we try to do for the positive aspect of what we're trying to work with. Just think about it. Okay. So that list is quite extensive, but if you're reading through each one of those, I guarantee you everybody can relate to just a little. And I just went through all of it and just talked a little bit about it. So take the time to read it. Take a look on No Finish Line Nation. Take a look on Connect on Instagram and check the list out. And then you guys can screenshot it if you want to and print it. And when you print it, stick it somewhere where you can see it. I've got it on my desk at work. And now I'm going to put it on my fridge. Because I think it's really important to remember some of this stuff. It's really important to stay humbled. It's really important to listen to others. It's important to give back all the things that we're trying to do to keep our mindset right, to make sure that we're in a good place where we can have our journeys and be successful with ours. So take a look at it and tell me what your thoughts are. And I'm hoping it helps you as much as it did me. And, you know, hey, again, I just want to share with all of you, I appreciate every single one of you guys for listening, putting up with my nonsense sometimes, and really just hunkering down and keep sharing the thoughts. And again, I know at the end, it kind of shares at the end outro, is to leave some feedback on iTunes for me. Get on there. Give me a star rating, whatever you think it's worth giving the star rating, and then put some writing comments for me, guys. The more I can get of those, the better that we can put together a nice little snapshot of when other people are scouring through podcasts, they can look at it and say, oh, what's this guy all about, right? Or what's this podcast all about? The more of those, the better. If you guys can just take a little bit of time for me and just pop in there and leave some feedback, it'd be really helpful. So we'll talk later, guys, and have a great, great, great Tuesday.
Thank you so much for listening to this episode of Coffee Talk with Liquidshano 1973. You can also find us on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook just by searching for Liquidshano 1973. Also, do us a favor if you can and leave us some love and rate us on iTunes whenever you get a chance. Until next time, we'll see you on the next Coffee Talk, and make it a great day.